الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الأولين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. We continue with another major sign of the hour, and this is lecture number 2, talking about Yajuj wa Majuj. Alhamdulillah, we spoke in details about the transitional sign. Imam Muhammad ibn Abdullah al-Mahdi and his emerging. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعجل به يا رب العالمين. And we spoke also about the greatest fitna of the end of time, which is al-Masih al-Dajjal, and its association with the second coming of Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wassalam. And we started talking about Ya'juj and Ma'juj being also one of the tasks of Nabiullah Isa alayhi salatu wassalam. We know that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam already identified the work which Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wassalam will do when he descends again into earth. And this is why, ya ikhwa, we believe that Prophet Isa is not bringing anything new. He's actually going to come down to simply follow what was already laid out for him to do. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam already identified what he should do. So there is no more abrogation, or there is no more revelation to the Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being the conclusion of the Sharia to mankind, except one tiny piece. You know what it is? No more jizya Prophet Isa will accept. That's the only piece that Prophet Isa will actually abrogate, because it is tied to his coming. We know that if there is a Christian or a Jew who's living within the boundaries of a Muslim state, they are allowed to keep their faith, to stay Christian, to stay Jews, as long as they pay the jizya. But when Prophet Isa alayhi salam descends again, comes back again, there is no more what? Huh? No more jizya. يلغي الجزية. He will abolish the jizya. Basically Islam or die. For the sake of time here, the task of Ya'juj and Ma'juj is one of the toughest tasks, which Prophet Isa alayhi salam will not really do whole a lot, except he would take the believers and he would confine them. He would seek protection, a safe haven, on a top of a mountain called the Tur. حرز عبادي بجبل الطور. Now we do have two mountains called the Tur, one of them in Palestine and one of them in Sinai. Which one, we don't know. But over there he will just be making dua to get rid of that fitna of Ya'juj and Ma'juj. Normally, ikhwa, when we study the major signs of the hour in particular, we try to figure out a particular for each sign. Like, let's take, for example, the Dajjal. What is the particular of the Dajjal? Where is the test? In what area is the test? في التوحيد. And your knowledge of the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know that Allah cannot be what? Seen in this world. This is in itself would help you against the Dajjal. You know that Allah is not a human being. That Allah is perfect. He is the creator. He cannot have a defect in his creation. In his essence. The knowledge of Tawheed, especially the names and the attributes, would save you from what? From the Dajjal. The fitna of Ya'juj and Ma'juj. What is the particular, what is so special about this fitna? Corruption. Ya'juj and Ma'juj are the symbol, if this is proper English, alama, yani, symbol, or you call it symbol, right? S-Y-M-B-O-L, huh? Symbol. The symbol of corruption. Look, immediately when Dhul Qarnayn approached the people, what did they say to him? What is the first thing that he said to them? Ya Dhul Qarnayn, O Dhul Qarnayn, Inna Ya'juj wa Ma'juj, huh? Mufsiduna fil ard. Al-fasad fil ard. Corruption. That's what Ya'juj and Ma'juj is all about. And they are so corrupt that Dhul Qarnayn could not reform them. You know, when you see somebody who's corrupt, you could try to do what? Fix them. Basically, he had a zero a tolerance of them that he ended up what? Get out of here. There is no single hope that you can become good people. So the best way is to do what? Place them behind that iron, molten, well-built wall. Yani, top of the line engineering. If you're an engineer and you know how the Qarnayn came up with this idea. Now, look at this now. I'm still driving this to the issue of corruption. في البخاري ومسلم, Zainab bint Jahsh radiyallahu anha, a wife of Nabiyina sallallahu alayhi wasallam, one day she said the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam woke up from his sleep so alarmed, fazi'an. His face actually was red, muhmar al-wajh. And he's saying what? لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ويل للعرب من شر قد اقترب. Woe to the Arabs from an evil which is approaching them. And he did what? فتح اليوم من ردم يأجوج ومأجوج. And he did with the index and the what do you call this? The thumb and the index, like this. So they were able to dig the wall that much. Meaning they are about to do what? They are about to come out, break through. Because we know that every single day from Hadith al-Nawas ibn Sam'an al-Kilabi, that every single day the wall where they are behind right now, they actually try to dig through it. Dig, 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 until they're actually about to see the rays of the sun from the other side. Yani they're about to. But their leader would say what? Let's come back tomorrow without saying what? Insha'Allah. And subhanAllah, when they return tomorrow, they would find the whole what? Filled back in. So they have to start over. So during the time of the Prophet ﷺ, he became alarmed that they were able to what? Not just see the rays, but they were able to what? Actually dig a hole. Normally the rays, you could see it from what? A little tiny, but here is what I'm looking for in the hadith. Zainab bint Jahsh radiallahu anha, the wife of the Prophet, says to him, she asked him, Ya Rasulallah, anahlaku wa fina salihun? Can those people break through and basically destroy us when we have righteous amongst us? What did he say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Yes. Either kathura al-khabath. When corruption, khabath is really, you could say adultery, you could say injustice, you could say oppression. Khabath is everything that is bad when it is widespread. Why? Because there is no muslihin. There are salihin. There is a difference between what? Muslih wa salih. What is the difference between the two? Salih, he's righteous in himself. But say he doesn't see, he doesn't hear, he doesn't speak. He sees something wrong. But what is a muslih? When he sees something wrong, he deals with it. هذا هو المصلح. فزينب said, يا رسول الله, can we be destroyed when we have righteous? She did not say مصلحون. قالت أنهلك وفينا الصالحون. He said, yeah. They are righteous, but they did not stop what? الخبث, corruption from what? From spreading. وهذا المعنى في القرآن. يعني احنا قرأنا عليكم ها في سورة هود. If you were reflecting upon the Quran, فلولا كان أولو بقي من القرون من قبلكم أولو بقية ينهون عن الفساد في الأرض. Look at the next verse. وما كان ربك ليهلك القرى بظلم وأهلها مصلحون. Allah will never destroy the nations when the people are what? مش صالحون. مصلحون. What is مصلح? Someone, he sees evil and he tries to change it. شوف, look at this. والذين يمسكون بالكتاب. And those who hold fast to the teachings of the Quran and the Sunnah. وأقاموا الصلاة. And they establish the salah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ الْمُصْلِحِينَ. مش الصالحين, المصلح. Again, what the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling Zainab bint Jahsh, that if those righteous people do not turn into reformers, مصلحون, huh? Yes, Yajuj and Majuj will. So the corruption, that pool, that sea, that ocean of corruption that Dhul Qarnayn saved the earth from, will what? Will pour out. وشوف إيه, حتى إذا فتحت يأجوج ومأجوج وهم من كل حدب ينسلون. They will come out from every place. They swarm swiftly out from every place, every mountain, every place, every valley, they just pour out there. فهذه العلامة يا إخوة, يعني we study it, it's very interesting, but this is what we need to reflect upon. I'll give you another example quickly before we go into يأجوج and مأجوج. حديث عبد الله بن عمر أخرجه ابن ماجة. Beautiful حديث, حديث صحيح, authentic. Chain wise, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Ya ma'ashar al-muhajireen. He one day addressed the immigrants, al-muhajireen. Khamsu khisal. Three things, bad things. Idha btulitu bihin. If you are inflected with them. Wa a'udhu billahi an tudrikuhun. And I seek refuge with you that Allah would prolong your lives until you live, until you see them. Rasulullah did not say that they are not going to happen. They will happen. But he's seeking refuge that the immigrants would live until what? They see them. Number one. لم تظهر الفاحشة في قوم حتى يعلنوا بها إلا وفشى فيهم الطاعون والأوجاع التي في أسلاف التي لم تكن في أسلافهم الذين مضوا من قبلهم. Lewdness. You know what lewdness mean? Lewdness. الفاحشة. فاحشة. Huh? That people will look at فاحشة or it will spread till people regard it as a common open practice. Adultery, it's becoming what? Billahi alik, even you're a Muslim. I mean, you're a Muslim who's right now, when you hear a man and a woman are together, you're not. Okay. Before, remember these old days when you were back home? Astaghfirullah. A'udhu billah. Ya Allah, these guys are not married. Your blood is what? Muslims now. What is the danger of living in? Why the warning against living amongst the kuffar? Why? Why? لأن قلبك يأتلف الإيه. Your heart becomes what? It's no longer sensitive to what? I mean, I hate to give this example, but I have to give it. You know, when I go back home, you heard me saying before, but this is the example that really... okay, there is a better example. It's not as stinky as that example that I want to say. If somebody smokes, if somebody smokes, stands next to somebody who smokes, do you think he smells his smoke? I guess I'm not... let me articulate myself. Does the smoker smell the smoke of the smoker? He doesn't smell it. You know this, right? Of course, some of you, they never smoked, right? You guys are good. Look at this. If somebody smokes and you stand next to somebody who smokes, you don't smell his smoke. You don't. Even if you smell his what? But if you're not a smoker, you stand next to somebody who smokes, astaghfirullah, what is this guy? He can't even bear it, but if you stand next to him, he's a smoker. He's like... maybe that example did not serve, so I'm going to give you the stinky example. You know, we have in Egypt that running sewage, human sewage, called Bahr al-Ba'r. Subhanallah, they call Bahr al-Ba'r. So when I go home from the airport, wallahi, I have to cross. It's like in my way to my village. So I have to cross over. So of course, here I am coming. And then when I have to do like this, otherwise I'm going to vomit. It's a human sewage and open, not like covered. You smell. But here is the amazing piece, that around it, there are houses and homes and people are living. So you look around and say, how in the world those people are able to afford that smell? The brothers, they tell me, after 3 days, they don't smell a thing. They don't. Khalas, they're what? They became corrupt. Likewise, us, we come here and look right now, subhanAllah, the same-sex marriage. Huh? It's becoming like, you're here with what? When you hear a man with a man, and you're here with be what? Wallahi, I remember, we were the other day in Abu Bakr sitting and discussing how can we counsel them and give them comfort. And say, yes, salam. And we got our lawyer standing in front of everybody, celebrate, celebrate, celebrate. Ya Habibi, celebrate. Allah al-Musta'an. A problem. Now you see fahisha, lewdness all over the place. And look at the consequence of this. إِذَا ظَهَرْ لَمْ تَظْهَرِ الْفَاحِشَةِ What will happen? Allah will inflict the people with diseases that they never heard of before. Isn't that what we see? AIDS, مش عارف إيه. طب look at number one. وَلَمْ يَنْقُصُ الْمِكْيَالَ وَالْمِيزَانِ Cheating. They end up cheating in the measure and in the weight. What will happen? إِلَّا وَأُخِذُوا بِالسِّنِينَ No rain. And this is why, if you're wondering why there is no rain in back in the Muslim world. Hardly you find rain over here, because there is justice here to some extent. There is some sort of normally cheating. You could cheat, but you know, it's not as easy as you do there. Cheating out there is the practice. Yani, when you trade, when you sell, when you buy, you're supposed to do what? You cheat. Being honest is what? Is the odd thing. Look at this. وَلَمْ يَنْقُسُ الْمِكْيَالَ وَالْمِيزَانِ إِلَّا أُخِذُوا بِالسِّنِينَ No rain. وَشِدَّةِ الْمَؤُونَةِ The prices will be going up. وَجَوْرُ السُّلْطَانِ And Allah will boot on them rulers who will abuse them. طب, look number three. So what was number one? فاحشة, lewdness. Number two, cheating in general. Number three, وَلَمْ يَمْنَعُوا زَكَاةَ أَمْوَالِهِمْ إِلَّا وَمُنِعُوا الْقَطْرِ People stop paying their zakat al-mal, no more rain. No more rain, no water. وَلَوْلَا الْبَهَائِمْ Has it been for the animals? وَلَوْلَا الْبَهَائِمْ مَا أُمْطِرُوا يعني the little rain that comes down is because of what? Not because of the human, because of the animals. طب شوف number five, number four, وَلَمْ يَنْقُضُوا عَهْدَ اللَّهِ وَعَهْدَ رَسُولِهِ That you renounce the covenant that لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله praying five times and that you do not fulfill the requirements of being a Muslim except what? Allah will send an enemy who will chastise them and he will take away from their what they have. Look, وَمَا لَمْ تَحْكُمْ أَئِمَّتُهُمْ بِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ وَيَتَخَيَّرُونَ مِمَّا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا جَعَلَ بَأْسَهُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ شَدِيدٌ سبحان الله. And if the rulers do not rule according to the book of Allah, what will happen? Civil war. Arabic Spring. Right here, Mo. They will fight one another. Again, ya ikhwa, why? Why? Because there is corruption. All of these five things are what? Corruption. They will lead to corruption. And this is where the punishment comes collectively. This is what Ya'juj and Ma'juj is all about. So they will keep digging every day. Digging every day. Digging every day. As they try to dig, and corruption is increasing in earth. Corruption is increasing, corruption is increasing, corruption is increasing until the appointed time is here, they will break through and they will wipe what? Everyone else except the few believers who will be in the company of who? Of original Mahdi and then later on with the Prophet Isa alayhi salam. طيب. Let's go over hadith al-Nawas ibn Sam'an al-Kilabi radiyallahu anhu. And you're going to enjoy this hadith. It's one of the lengthy hadith fi sunnah. Inna ya'juja wa ma'juja la yahfuruna sadda kulla yawm. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells you. Every single day ya'juj and ma'juj are digging through that womb. حتى إذا كادوا أن يرون أشعة الشمس until they're about to see the rays of the sun قال الذي عليهم meaning their Amir, the leader will say to them ارجعوا let's go back, we got tired فستحفرونه غدا and let's carry on digging it tomorrow فيعودون they will come back in the morning فيعودون إليه كأشد ما كان من الغد they will find it stronger filled again that hole is filled and the wall is restored and it's harder than yesterday حتى إذا بلغت مدتهم, until the appointed time. ما هو when ذي القرنين build the wall, what did he say? قال هذا رحمة من ربي. This is out of Allah's mercy upon the immediate people. But look at this. فإذا جاء وعد ربي, when the promise of Allah is here, جعله دكاء. It will be destroyed. They will be able to break through that wall. وكان وعد ربي حقا. And the promise of Allah certainly is a true promise. When this promise is, a short period after Prophet Isa عليه الصلاة والسلام kills the Dajjal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reveal to him that I'm about to allow, permit slaves of mine, no one can dare fight them or even face them, to break through, to exit. إني أذنت لعبادي لي بالخروج. So they will what? They will exit. فحرز عبادي بجبل الطور. Take those few Muslims who were out there all the time through the fitan with the Imam al-Mahdi fighting Armageddon and they went through with the Dajjal and all of this. And subhanAllah, ikhwa, one of the most fascinating things that when Prophet Isa alayhi salam descends, he will actually come and wipe over their heads and their faces like this, the believers. And he will remind them of their ranks in Jannah. وَيُذَكِّرُهُمْ بِدَرَجَاتِهِمْ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. And this is how you understand the hadith, hadith Muawiyah, رضي الله عنه, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي ظاهرين على الحق. A group of my ummah will always be standing for the truth, standing on the truth, defending the truth. That's what it meant. All of this. Until what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends to them who? Isa عليه السلام. For these Muslims, believers who are out there for the cause of Islam, they refuse to stay righteous in themselves only. Rather, they were out there trying to reform. They wanted to be muslihun. Huh? They wanted to fix the world around them, change the spectrum of corruption around them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send Prophet Isa to protect them, to take them to a mountain called At-Tur. So a short period after Prophet Isa kills the Dajjal, Prophet Isa alayhi salam will be informed of the release of Ya'juj and Ma'juj from behind the iron built wall. Prophet Isa alayhi salam will take the Muslims to a mountain called At-Tur for their protection, as nobody will be able to fight Ya'juj and Ma'juj. They will come down from every lofty place causing destruction, Ya'juj and Ma'juj. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned two things which indicate their destruction. The first batch of them, of Ya'juj and Ma'juj, will pass by a lake in Palestine called Tabariyah. اللي هو إيه الجليلي الجليل النهر. Imagine this. They will drink all of its water, of its water, all the water they will drink it. To the extent that the last batch will come to it, and they will say what? Once there were water here, there was water here. Imagine this. We're talking about 9/10 of the human being, of the race of the human beings. based on Hadith Abi Sa'id in the hereafter, أخرج بعث النار, take out the delegation. We're talking about 9/10 البشر. Imagine this. They will march on killing everyone. In some wording, by the way, that in some of the explanation of المفسدون في الأرض, that they will eat the human. They will drink their blood, like the Dracula. So marching on, carrying out murders to their right and to their left, to the extent that they will no longer see a human on earth. The believers are weird, and the people who are smart, if they are not with Prophet Isa, if they are righteous and pious and they know the Sunnah, they should be weird, hiding in the mountains. So they will look around and they will say, what? We killed all the inhabitants of earth. Let us now kill the inhabitants of the heaven. قَتَلْنَا أَهْلَ الْأَرْضِ لِنَقْتُلْ أَهْلِ السَّمَاءِ. Subhanallah, Allah will expose to them to fitna. They will shoot their arrows up. They will shoot their arrows. And their arrows, after they shoot it towards the sky, Allah will return their arrows soaked with blood, covered with blood. They will think they have also killed the inhabitants of the heaven. Fitna for them. Angels do not die, right? Malaika la yamutu, but fitna for who's dwelling in the heavens? There are human in the heavens. Angels have blood. Huh? Malaika has blood. Malak malush. Malaika are created from what? Noor, light. It's a fitna for them. It's in a way to increase them in what? طيب, where's Prophet Isa عليه السلام? Meanwhile, Prophet Isa عليه السلام وأصحابه and his companions are confined, but they are so hungry. Imagine this, that the head of an ox, ثور, رأس الثور, would be more valuable than 100 golden coins. Just the head of what? Normally you don't eat the head of the ox. Unless if you just want to eat the brain and stuff like that. But basically you don't really, but imagine, they are so hungry. They are in need to eat. But subhanallah, look at the power that Allah will give to Prophet Isa alayhi salam at this time. فَيَرْغَبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ. They will make dua, Ya Rab, Ya Rab, relieve us from this fitna. They will make dua for the destruction of Ya'juj and Ma'juj. Look at this now. Imagine, in spite of their might and power and strength, Allah will send a worm. A worm. وَلَكَ وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. Only Allah knows his soldiers. Imagine. Look at this man power. A worm called the nagaf, an insect. They tell you it's a worm that grows in the nose of a camel. Allah will send insects, worms, attacking them, biting their necks from this area. In the morning, they will be dead like one soul. Like all of them will die what? One time, one night, overnight. Dua, huh? Dua. Who's making dua? Prophet Isa alayhi salam. Ya Rab. Look at this. الحديث هذا في ذكره القرطبي في التذكرة, حديث أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه. The believers will not be able to withstand the noise of them as they are being attacked by these insects. They will make noise when they are attacked by the insects, that the believers will hear them on the top of the mountains as they are dying. And they will say to one another, الحديث هذا صحيح شيخ الألباني. It's authentic. Can anyone sacrifices his life and see what is going on down there? So all they hear is what? Noise. But they don't know what's happening. Sayyidina Isa and the believers are asking a volunteer for someone to what? Expedition. Just find out what's going on with that with the people there. So basically they are looking for what? Someone, death squad basically. Somebody to go and actually sacrifice himself. A believer volunteering will come down from the mountain thinking that he will never return. To his surprise, he will find out that they are all dead. All of them are dead on earth. But now their bodies are so stinky. Stinking, the smell. So Prophet Isa and the believers, يَرْغَبُونَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ. Oh Allah, help us. We can't live in this earth because their bodies are all over their corpse, I guess it would be corpse, right? Corpses are all over the place. And they cannot handle the skin, the smell. Prophet Isa and his companions will come down, but they will find out earth is full of their stinking corpses. They will make dua again. Allah will send birds with necks like the necks of the camels. Allah will send birds. The necks of these birds is as long as the camel neck. And subhanAllah, they will carry their bodies and they will throw them someplace Allah knows best. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not specify. Where exactly? He did not specify. Look at this now. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send rain, which no house of mud, brick, or tent of camel hair, but it will wash the earth. That rain will reach every place. That earth will look like a mirror. Complete, clean, new earth. So Prophet Isa alayhi salam will come down with the believers. And subhanallah, he will rule out of Jerusalem. Justice will be established. And like corruption was a reason for the blessings of Allah to be taken out of earth, look at this now, the barakah will be brought back to earth again. Allah will command the earth to bring forth its fruits and to restore its blessings. Look, Ikhwa, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam dhakar, he mentioned examples. ثُمَّ يُقَالُ لِلْأَرْضِ أَنْبِتِي ثَمَرَكَ وَرُدِّي بَرَكَتَكَ فَيَوْمَئِذٍ تَأْكُلُ الْعِصَابَةُ مِنَ الرُّمَّانِ وَيَسْتَضِلُّونَ بِقَحْفِهَا. Imagine 12 people will eat from the palm granite. Huge baraka, and they will use the skin as what? As a shade. Why, ya ikhwa? Because there is no what? No corruption. There is justice, Sharia. Because Prophet Isa alayhi salam will what? Will rule out of where? Out of Jerusalem. And one of the things that he will do is what? يَقْضِي بِالشَّرِيعَةِ. When there is Sharia, there is justice. I care less what CNN says, what Bill O'Reilly says, what Fox says. Sharia is justice. Shar'ullah. The Sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in earth. There is justice. That's what Prophet Isa alayhi salam is going to use to establish justice in earth. And as a result of this, no corruption. As a result of this, barakah is what? Remember at the very beginning we quoted Hadith Abdullah ibn Umar that when the people do not pay the zakah, when people cheat regarding the scale, regarding the measurements, regarding the weight, when lewdness, adultery, and openly sinning people are out there speaking of their sin, all of this would lead to what? To a collective punishment. Likewise, when there is justice, when the Sharia is there, and there is no open sinning in the community, likewise the barakah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down, security comes down. To the extent that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, وَيُبَارِكُ اللَّهُ فُي الرَّسْلِ. الرَّسْلِ اللي هو الايه؟ The milk. To the extent that a group of people would drink the milk of a camel and they would be full. The milk of a cow will be sufficient for a whole tribe. One cow. Barakah. ما هو يا إخوة, the problem that we have right now is not about money. It's about what? The barakah. وشوف الآية, اقرأ الآية, ولو أن أهل القرى آمنوا واتقوا لفتحنا عليهم. If the people of the town do believe and have taqwa, we will open what? لفتحنا عليهم, not أرزاق, what? بركات, blessings. We will bless what they have. The problem that we have a lot of resources, but the problem is what? ما فيش بركة. There is no بركة in it. Why? Because there is injustice out there. Subhanallah, ikhwa. In closing, inshallah, so we maybe take some questions from you. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, طوبى لعيش بعد المسيح. ورد. We know that we have more than one hadith that when Prophet Isa alayhi salam descends, he's going to spend 40 years. And we have another hadith that says he's going to spend 7 years. So how do you put the two together? I'm asking you. We have one hadith that says he's going to spend 40 years. And another hadith that says he's going to spend 7 years. Huh. 7 years what? Okay, that's very good. When he was raised, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the age of 33. Prophet Isa, when they plotted to crucify him, he was at the age of 33. So he's going to come down and rule for how many? That will make it 40 years. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, طوبى لعيش بعد المسيح. This is the best time earth will ever experience. بركة. قل لك, لو بذرت حبك على الصفا. Imagine this, if you throw seeds on a rock, cement, it will grow. Again, because of what? There is what? Justice. That's what Prophet Isa alayhi salam, justice. Oh. Everyone is a Muslim. There is no other religion but Islam. People are, they tell you that at this time a person will be taking his zakatul mal. Imagine this. Right now we're begging people in the minbar, reminding them of zakatul mal. Imagine at his time, the person will be taking his zakatul mal and going around, can you please accept my zakat, please? Imagine, he's begging the people to what? To accept his zakatul mal. Get out of here. We do not need him. The children will play with the snakes. The snakes will become what? Harmless. قرأنا إخوة في سيرة عمر بن عبد العزيز رحمه الله. The biography of عمر بن عبد العزيز. That a scholar used to live in the desert. Umar ibn al-Aziz did not rule for a long time. So a scholar used to live in the desert that he didn't want to be engaged in the fitan. He just, you know, he took the... See, he noticed that the wolves are playing with the sheep. Normally a wolf would do what to the sheep? Eat the sheep. When a wolf spots a sheep, right away. So he noticed that the wolves are no longer eating the sheep, rather they are guarding what? So he decided to come down to Medina and said, who's ruling? Look at the man, look at his fiqh. He's a alim. He said, there must be a just ruler. Things must have changed. So he comes down and he finds the Umar ibn Abdul Aziz is the ruler. He actually went and he told him, he said, you're a just ruler. Because this is the sign. Because this is what Isa right here. The wolf will no longer, actually they will guard the kids will be playing with the snakes, which are supposed to be harmful. They will become harmless. Why? Because there is justice. So this will take place, ya ikhwa, this will happen for a duration of time. Some of the scholars, they said almost 1,000 years. Actually, the impact of Prophet Isa will be almost 1,000 years. Yani some of the wording. Of course, he will die. It was also narrated that he's going to go and perform Hajj and Umrah, or one of them, whether Hajj or whether Umrah. Then he will die. There is an author out there that he will be buried next to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is one spot left out there, by the way, next to Abu Bakr, Umar, and Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Muslims will pray janaza on him. But his impact will continue after him for a duration of time. Then what will happen again? Look at this now. You know the minor signs that we have now, which really about to be done? They will gradually reintroduce themselves again. Again. So these minor signs, they will what? They will actually come in between the two sets of major signs. So again, killing will gradually start again. Adultery will gradually start again. So all these bad things will gradually what? Begin again. But this time with no what? With no return. Subhanallah, ya ikhwah. Right then, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send the wind. In some of the wording, that wind will come from Yemen. Another wording, it will come from Sham, Syria. That wind will suffocate the believers, the people who have faith in their hearts, will cause them to die. They will die. Look, death is a relief. And only the worst of mankind will be left on earth. The worst of mankind. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, لا تقوم الساعة إلا على شرار الناس. And subhanAllah, they will begin experiencing the other set of the major signs, that one morning they will wake up and they will see the sun rising from the west. What's going on? And then the beast will come out, Dab, that will tell them, you guys are dummy, you don't believe in Allah, basically. And then things will start going bad, 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 awful, 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 awful. Until, subhanAllah, warad fil hadith, أَنَّ النَّاسَ يَتَهَارَجُونَ تَهَارُجُ الْحُمُرُ, that the people will commit adultery on the side of the streets, openly. They will go back to the worship of idols. People will go back to the worship of idols. When the Prophet ﷺ actually narrated this hadith in front of Aisha radiallahu anha, you know what she said? Ya Rasulullah, didn't we read in the Quran, هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله? Don't we read in the Quran that Allah sent Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam with the true guidance and with Deen al-Haq, with the guidance and the true religion in order to make it rise above? I said, this will happen. But towards the end of time, no. It will go back to what? This is when Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala will bring a guy from Abyssinia called Dussuwaiqatayn. The way that he walks like a Dajjal, he will go and he will take down the Kaaba a brick by brick. He will take down the Kaaba. And by the way, he's going to take it down and nobody even know, because nobody performs Hajj anyways. Nobody performs Umrah anyways. Imagine this. He will go take down the Kaaba without anybody what? Careless about it. Because there is no Salah aslan. يعني ورد في حديث حذيفة بن اليماني واصلة تنجيهم من النار that the people will say all what they remember Allah, Allah, Allah. The Sufi like this one, is it? شايف هو يقول لك الله الله الله. ف the people will ask who's Allah Allah, what is this? Oh, my grandfather used to say that word. They don't even know what Allah Allah is. My grandfather used to what? Zero. There is no deen at all. Ya ikhwa, you know that we know when the hour will take place? When is the hour will take place? On a Friday morning, between Fajr and the sunrise. Warad fil hadith that even the animals know this. If you're a farmer, just go to your farm every Friday morning. I tried this myself. You would see animals actually moving, making movements, that funny movements. It's uncomfortable. Imagine, that is why the best Fajr that you should pray in the masjid, what Fajr? Well, like Fajr al-Jum'ah. Imagine, even we have a taste of people like this, like Fajr al-Jum'ah, they are not in the masjid, they are asleep. Well, like, and what is the sunnah regarding Fajr al-Jum'ah? What is the other sunnah regarding Fajr al-Jum'ah? In general, يعني, besides the sajda wal-insan, what should you do, the imam? Prolong the recitation. يقول لك, طول القراءة. يعني, in general, if you're not going to read it sajda in al-insan, if you read another Quran, just what? Prolong what? Because the hour could, it's good that you die what? When you're what? You're in salah. The hour, subhanallah, will take place. Bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, next Wednesday, we're going to begin talking about the events of the Day of Judgment. That's going to be a very interesting. We're going to begin with the events of the Day of Judgment, the scenes of the Day of Judgment. Mashahidu yawm al-qiyamah. Huh? What is the first scene? What? Destruction. Everything will be what? Destroyed. في مسند الإمام أحمد حديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says من سره أن ينظر إلى يوم القيامة نظر رأي عين. If you want to visualize what will happen when the Day of Judgment is here, اقرأ, read. إذا الشمس كورت إذا السماء انفطرت إذا السماء انشقت. Those are three chapters, right? التكوير, الانفطار, الانشقاق. If you want to know what's happening, just read those three chapters. Everyone, every living person will die. Now everyone is dead. Then what will happen after that? The next scene is what? Now the resurrection of all of what? Of mankind. After the resurrection, they will be driven to the land of gathering. That is called Yawm al-Hashr. What is al-Hashr? The day of what? Of gathering. They will stand there for years. Allah will come in a way that suits His Majesty to begin reckoning. So inshallah we're going to go through these scenes one by one, inshallah. And again, ya ikhwa, the purpose is not to scare, rather to prepare for this بإذن الله تعالى. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والحمد لله رب العالمين.